a larger perspective of, well, what is controlling metabolism? And what does it even mean to have a metabolic disorder? What does a metabolic disorder mean? And make no mistake, metabolic disorders are real.
Oh, yeah.
We call them obesity and type 2 diabetes and cardiovascular disease. And it turns out people with mental illness are more likely to have those disorders. And it turns out people with those disorders are more likely to have mental illness. And when you ask big picture questions like that, like what is metabolism? What's controlling it? What does it mean to have metabolic dysfunction? It leads you to mitochondria. And over the last 25 years, the scientific field has exploded in terms of helping us better understand exactly all of the different roles that mitochondria play in cells. And when you do a deep dive into the science of all of those roles, you start to learn that mitochondria are actually the primary regulators of neurotransmitters and neurotransmitter release. You learn that mitochondria are actually the primary regulators of hormones like cortisol, estrogen, and testosterone. You learn that mitochondria are primary regulators of inflammation. Mitochondria are primary regulators of the function and structure and development of cells. And when you understand that, you can begin to connect all of the risk factors for mental illness. And when you look at the big picture and ask yourself, well, what happens if a cell doesn't have enough mitochondria? Or if those mitochondria are somehow deficient? You actually end up with a fairly simplistic model of how a cell can malfunction.